in the surgery of locally advanced lung cancer. No small cell lung cancer. Oh, was serious. Locally advanced lung cancer amounts to a little bit higher than most of the patients who come to specialized institutions. Combined pneumonectomy with the resection of chest wall by Evans Graham was the beginning of the new era of lung cancer treatment. The patient outlived his doctor and was present at the doctor's funeral. This is the method of choice up to now. Classification of surgeries developed by Professor Trachtenberg is still topical. You see, combined surgeries are divided in tracheobronchoesophageal type, vascular atrial type, and parietal diaphragmal type. Indications for such surgeries: true tumor invasion, primary invasion, invading lymph nodes and surrounding structures, paragon growth changes, and the necessity of optimal distance from the tumor to secure optimal resection. Prognosis is seen in a new light based on the 8th revision of classification based on 7,000 cases. Very detailed stratification of all the main criteria, TNM, was performed in great detail. Depending, there is a trend here, depending on each subgroup, we see worsening of the prognosis. Even third stage has 5 years survival of 36%, 3 stage. T, or size of the tumor, preserves its prognostic importance in all the indices and gives more detailed stratification in terms of the level and intensity, while M reflects generalization. Mediastinal lymphodissection its necessity raises no doubt among thoracic surgeons, because it has been proven that the potential of metastatic involvement of regional lymph nodes is quite high, even in initial cancer less than 2 centimeters. Predictive and prognostic factors among locally advanced resectable lung cancer are resectability of the tumor, efficacy of induction therapy, if any, the status of the intra-chest lymph nodes, the volume of the operation, and the age of the patient. All publications dealing with combined broad operations in case of lung cancer have different parameters, including mortality and 5 years survival. Why so? Because invasion various extrapulmonary structures may have different prognoses. Ingrowth into pericardium, for example. By grouping this heterogeneous group, we have such different results. Prognostic heterogeneity of extrapulmonary advance of the oncoprocess. The best results may be seen when the tumor ingrowth in the pericardium, pulmonary vessels, upper vena cava, left atrium, and tracheal carina. Unfavorable esophagus, backbone,
Данный слайд
and mediastinum.
Наглядно показывает зависимость выживаемости не от
That's
уровня
how the survival depends not on N2 and N1, but the intensity of involvement, multiple stations or single station. N2 has the worst prognosis compared to N1, because the majority percent of patients with N2 have multiple metastases in the lymph nodes.
Можно привести десятки контраргументов за и против
Hundreds of counter-arguments for and against surgery in locally advanced lung cancer may be given. One of them is concealed generalization of the tumor process. Micrometastases may be present in the majority of these patients and they may be implemented in the near future in the clinical variants. But there are many
Например, осложненное течение заболеваний, не позволяющее провести не то, что противоопухолевую специфическую терапию, но и симптоматическую терапию этих больных, этих хирургических вмешательств также имеются. И
мы можем эффективность нахождения консервативной терапии
при большой массивной опухоли,
а также более хирургически
обеспечить
Only surgery may secure a chance of stable survival of this patient. Adequate pre-op staging is needed and functional operability. In our clinic, in the course of 10 years, of 1800 something patients with no small cell lung cancer, combined surgeries amounted to 386 or 21%, tracheobronchial resections 117, vascular atrial resections 207. And perioded the first group tracheobronchial resection surgeries with the resection of tracheal bifurcation are considered to be one of the most difficult ones in thoracic oncology. The number of interventions is not that high. Up to now, Vladimir Kharchenko and Vladimir Parkhanov have the most extended experience based on the literature.
The
tracheal carina reconstruction options, in all cases there were all circular resections of tracheal bifurcations. The number of these operations as of today are already 121. After pneumonectomies on the left and on the right, and partial resection by lobectomy with double slit reconstruction of the carina. Technical aspects of carinal resections are anastomosis with knotted sutures, invagination anastomosis, myoplastics of the anastomotic area is needed, and the use of mechanic ventilation.
Здесь наглядно показана опухоль небольших
размеров.
Она считается местно распространенной,
однако по размерам
небольшая опухоль правого гетендерального
уха,
анатомических особенностей, инвазирующая правотрахеобронхиальный угол без метастаза лимфатических узлов с недостением, не может считаться кандидатом для проведения, кандидатом для отказа в хирургическом лечении. И крайне благоприятный
Based
прогноз
on this,
после хирургического этапа лечения.
It is not worthwhile to refuse the
These
are the stages of upper lobectomy with circular carina resection, formation of anastomosis, edge resection of the pulmonary artery with double vena cava, two sleeve Y-shaped anastomosis formed, and the photo on day 25, fluorescent and water remotes, results of carinal resections. We assessed them based on the second two periods of work. First period was the introduction of such operations after mastering the methodology and the
techniques.
The results changed drastically. In multivariate.
Прогностические факторы основные – это
main период работы, возраст,
индукционная терапия,
period of work, age, induction therapy, volume of operation,
и мультиорганная резекция с сочетанием циркулярной резекции
и катализированной including circular abdominal cover resection. Different anastomosis plasty options. See how reliably the area of the latissimus dorsi failure. And here we use the pericardial flap on day 21. There was a bleeding with a penetration of pericardium and erosion of the pulmonary artery trunk. Survival median is 38 months. Main prognostic factors are stage of the disease and type of the treatment. Vascular atrial resections were carried out in 207 cases. Left atrium was resected in 53 cases, right atrium in 2, and the pulmonary artery has been resected, or its plasty performed in 109. 23 cases were resection and plasty of the upper vena cava. Mortality after these operations amounted to only 7%, lower than in case of cardinal resections. It is comparable with the standard surgery's mortality. Typical bronchoangioplasty. Extrapericardial part of the artery is resected fully. Anastomosis phrenicus. Macro preparation of the bronchoangioplasty. You see true invasion in the entry of the upper lobe bronchus and the trunk of the pulmonary artery. In one case, there was a very forceful tension, and it was impossible to perform circular anastomosis, and to end pericardial flap was used along the anterior wall of the pulmonary artery. It was autologous pericardium. And this is 3D reconstruction of this patient 8 months after the operation. Left atrium resection in 53 cases, stages of the operation, pneumonectomy, resection of left atrium, and atrium was resected with the use of the device. Left atrium was resected not only in case of tumor infiltration into the entrance to pulmonary veins, but also in case of true invasion of the pericardial wall. This patient came to us with massive tumor. Initially, we assumed it was mediastinal tumor, but then identified peripheral squamous cell cancer of the upper right lobe of the lung, with invasion of the into the alpha vena cava. After three cycles of chemotherapy with stabilization, surgery performed, multi-organ resection, expanded lobectomy, replacement of left vena cava, tracheal bifurcation, right and left atria. And we also had two cases of both atria resection. Histologically, due to expression of PDL, the patient progressed after 6 months and now is receiving therapeutic immunotherapy. On the background of which we see the partial regression of metastatic liver. Next group, peritoneal diaphragmal resections. 62 patients, mortality is 6.5%, long-term results will be presented in the near future because the concentration of these operations was as of lately. We wanted to objectively follow them up and calculate the survival.
Bad
cost cancer, 13 patients, various successes. We used radicality of the intervention was of importance. Two-stage intervention. Posterior stage is the resection of the backbone, spondylolisthesis at the level of the involved vertebrae. Second stage, primary tumor. Is resected in the volume of primary tumor. We unify the tactics of treatment of the third stage. There are various views on to this situation, as we already heard. In our case, we are trying all the time to carry out combined therapy with the majority of patients receiving combined therapy. And the inspiring factors of this treatment are the radicality of the treatment, which is possible, and the removal of different complications of the tumor process, but there is a very high risk of complications, labor intensive, and the costs may be considered as counter arguments. And only after trying various options of induction, chemotherapy surgery may be very efficient.